IBM Planning Analytics stores the data that you need for planning and analyses in cubes. And IBM Planning Analytics Workspace makes creating cubes easy. Before you begin, make sure that you're logged in as either a modeler or an administrator. And also make sure that you're in edit mode. You can tell you're in edit mode because the pencil icon in the top left corner will be blue. If your pencil icon is white, simply click on the icon to enter edit mode. So in the content tree, I'll identify the database where I want to create my cube. In this demonstration, I think I'll create my cube in the 24 retail database. I'll expand 24 retail and then right-click cubes. Then I'll click create cube. Next, I'll need to enter a name for my new cube. I'll call this one Demonstration Cube 1. And now, I'll add three different dimensions for my cube. In order to make a cube, you'll need at least two different dimensions. I think I'll use the month, product, and revenue dimensions. This will allow me to analyze the measure of revenue of different products over a time interval of months. I can either move the dimensions over individually by highlighting one and then clicking the right arrow, or I can multi-select two or more and then move them over all at once. The order in which you place the dimensions in the cube can affect the performance. Generally, you should order the smallest and most sparse dimensions before the larger and denser ones. So in most cases, order the dimensions with fewer members before dimensions with a higher number of members. But this isn't a strict rule, as some dimensions may have fewer members, but are denser with values per member. So to do this, I'll simply click on the dimension under cube dimensions, and then use the up and down arrows to move them. In my case, the revenue dimension is the smallest, so I'll move that to the top of the cube. And once I'm happy with my cube, I'll click create. Now as we can see, a view is created for the cube. But the view is empty. And that's because when you create a cube, you're really just creating the structure of the cube for data to reside in. If I expand cubes, you can see my new cube there. So quickly, I'll show you how you can import data into a cube. To import my data, I'm using a CSV file. If we take a look at my CSV file, we can see that I have columns for the leaf level product names, months, and revenue. Now I'll just drag and drop this file onto my cube, and I'm presented with some options. I had one header row in my file, so I'll leave the header rows set to 1. And then I'll define which columns of data are mapped to which dimensions. So my product column maps to the product dimension, revenue maps to revenue, month to month, and for my values, I'll set it to numeric because that's what they are. Then I'll click import. To see my new data, all I have to do is refresh the view. And there it is. I can also now create new views using my cube, edit business rules, delete it, or bookmark it. And there you have it, creating cubes in IBM Planning Analytics Workspace.